Today, we mourn the loss of the five journalists killed in a shooting at the Capital Gazette in Annapolis, Maryland. Rob Hiaasen is an assistant managing editor at the Capital Gazette. Coworkers and friends praising the man they called an excellent journalist and, above all, a generous person. Joining us now on the phone is Carl Hiaasen, a longtime columnist at the Miami Herald and Rob's brother. Carl, our deepest condolences, obviously, for your loss. You wrote a Facebook post about it and said you were devastated and heartsick, which I think a lot of people can understand. What do you want people to know about your brother this morning? So much of what we've heard just paints a picture of a beautiful man.
Yeah, he was. He was the rock of our family. He was the little brother, but he was still the guy who brought all of us together and kept us together when times were tough. But I think what he would want me to talk about is journalism and the importance of community journalism. He was killed while he was doing what he loved to do, which is to put out this newspaper for the people of Annapolis. He'd been a journalist in Palm Beach and in Baltimore and gone to work in Annapolis, and he was so proud of those reporters, the other editors, and what he would want me to say is everything that they do is for the readers, to put put news and facts in the hands of their readers. And you're just sitting at your desk one day trying to put a newspaper out for the folks who are waiting for that newspaper, and this sort of atrocity happens. But he was there. He believed in the mission and the craft of hometown journalism.
And he was really dedicated to helping to groom that next generation of reporters, of writers. Among them, as I understand it, your son Scott as well, who would talk about how he helped them.
My son Scott was a journalist for many years, and partly because of Rob's influence, probably more than my own. And then Rob was teaching at the University of Maryland. He was teaching journalism there, and as well as mentoring the younger reporters at the at the Capital Gazette. I mean, he rolled up his sleeves and he was in it and he believed in it. And this is a difficult time for all newspapers financially, demographically, and also for journalists who are under assault daily from the lunatic fringes of the social media who don't want the real facts to get in the hands of the people who need them. And so this is, Rob never thought of it as heroic. He thought of it as a civic duty, as a responsibility in a functioning democracy. But he was just this big, generous, gentle guy, and gifted, such a gifted writer and editor, as those who work with him will tell you or have told you.
We've heard a lot of mention made of him being Big Rob. Because he was tall, but yeah. That it was much more than his height, that his heart was big, his spirit was generous. And you've touched on that a little bit, but you even said in your post, he was big, but because he was tall, but was had remarkable heart and humor that made him larger than all of us. That's such an important gift to give to those, not only in your family, but those around you. And I imagine that's something that's really sustaining your sister-in-law and his children as well.
Yes, his wife. It was their it was her birthday yesterday, and they just recently celebrated the 33rd anniversary. And his children, of course. He was just one of those immense presence, and not just because of his size, but because of the warmth that he brought to every room and every situation. And this will probably never heal for all of us. But as we watched what's been happening in this country, and every this tragedy will eventually fall out of the headlines, and a few weeks from now we'll be replaced by another one with victims and families grieving just as ours is. It's this insane cycle of violence that we are now in the middle of, and it's a grimly predictable, tragically predictable. And this time our own family was, you know, and ironically, after writing, you know, I've been in the newspaper business for over 40 years. Rob was in it a long time. We've written about this sort of thing very, very often, and now it touches desperately close to home.
You talked too about not just about the rhetoric, but how journalists and journalism are both being attacked. Is that something that the two of you ever discussed, your concerns for your profession, for this important?
Not physical concerns, especially Rob, working for a relatively small paper. You think if it's a hometown newspaper, it's almost, you feel like a storefront operation. It's your hometown paper. You have a little bit different relationship with a smaller town than you do if you're working for, you know, obviously the Washington Post, New York Times, the Wall Street Journal. You have, you are a bigger physical target, and you have different layers of security that most small papers don't have and can't afford. And so it was nothing he and I had ever discussed. We talked about the rhetoric and the hatred, but we also reminded ourselves that in our whole lifetimes and careers, working journalists have never been at the top of the popularity list. Authority is authority, and you know, if you're doing your job as a journalist, you're usually pissing somebody off.
Yes.
Because you're getting out information that some people don't want to be revealed. But in this case, this lawsuit, you know, that this the alleged shooter, it goes back years and years, and it's been festering. His hatred has been festering for, what, 5 or 6, 7 years. How do you even predict or foresee or prepare yourself for that kind of madness and that kind of eruption? I'm sure Rob was aware that this guy had been tweeting had this gripe, but you know, you can't let it cripple you, you know, every day going in to work with a sense of being haunted by it. I mean, you go in and put out a newspaper. That's your job, and that's what the Capital Gazette staff did yesterday, despite this horrible, horrible tragedy.
Saying we're going to put out a damn paper, and they did.
We're going to, yeah. And he would have been so proud. He would have been so proud of them.
Before we let you go, what's your favorite memory you have of your brother? Something that just, without fail, if you think about that moment, it brings a smile to your face. Maybe it makes you laugh, but it's something that.
Well, I remember he was, as I said, he was a big guy, and when I was 6 years older than Rob, and I would come home from school, from college, and our father had died fairly young, and so Rob had been unwittingly sort of the man of the house but he was growing a lot, and I used to be able to sort of take him on, you know, as brothers do. You tussle and you wrestle, and then I remember coming home from college one day, and I think he just turned 15 or 16 maybe, whatever it was, and he just literally picked me up over his head and carried me in the house and threw me on the couch. It was his way of saying, "Those days are over. You're not going to win this wrestling match anymore." He was laughing the whole time. He was enormously strong, but he was just. I remember laughing like, "I said, what have you been eating, Jesus?" And we always, you know, he always would would kid about his size and just come into the house and sort of look down at the top of our heads. It was fun. But he was, you know, I remember him being that strong and also that gentle, you know. I don't think he ever hurt a fly in his life.
Gentle, generous, and still giving to so many this morning. Carl, we so appreciate you taking the time. I know it is tough for you and your family. We send our thoughts, our sincere condolences to you. Thank you.
And please, for his kids and his wife Maria as well, and this is just the nightmare of nightmares.
It is something no one should ever have to go through. We'll be right
Thank
back.
You.